Okay, quick.
Been out of their rooms?
No, I've been here all the time.
We've been barking at the wrong tree.
We'll soon find out. Mr. Weldon! Mr. Morton! Mr. Weldon!
Yes?
What is it?
We just wanted to see if you were all right.
Why shouldn't I be? What do you want now?
I'm afraid I owe you gentlemen an apology.
That's the least you can do.
I thought I could guard you here, but apparently the danger would be just as great in your own homes.
I don't understand.
The ghost got by the guards and reached this floor.
Did you see him?
Yes.
Well, who is he? Can you identify him?
Unfortunately, I can't. He was masked.
I tried to tell you it was foolish bringing us here.
We've been able to take care of ourselves so far.
I'm afraid I'll have to agree with both of you.
Then we're free to leave?
Yes, and I'll be glad to furnish a police escort if you wish.
That isn't necessary.
Well, there's one thing you can do for me.
What?
Tell me the hospital Brewster's in.
I'm sorry, under the circumstances, I don't think that advisable.
Probably you're right. I shouldn't have asked.
I'll be glad to keep in touch with you and let you know how he progresses.
Thank you.
Something screwy around here somewhere.
After what happened last night, I'm sure Tracy has been thrown off the track completely.
Now, if we can only locate Brewster and keep him from talking.
Yes? Corey.
You found Brewster.
Yeah, they've got him hidden in a private sanitarium. Sure, I know what room. He's in an oxygen tent. It won't be easy, but I'll take care of him. Right.
Mr. Brewster seems to be resting comfortably, but he may be unconscious for hours.
I'd like to be here when he comes to.
Well, why don't you wait in Dr. Jones's office, Mr. Tracy, and I'll call you as soon as there's any change in his condition.
Perhaps I'd better.
All right, I'll get it for you right away.
Tracy.
You can't come in here.
Yes, I can. Give me that phone.
What do you want?
Tracy. Is that you, Tracy?
No, I ain't Tracy.
Who are you?
Stop!
Sit quiet.
With that oxygen off you...
Yeah, I know. Get in there.
Back in the car.
What's up?
They killed Brewster. Stop a minute, Bill. Punch at the gas tank.
It'd be duck soup following a trail like that.
Right. I'm going to call Cosgrove at Hatton's flat car. Stand by. Into the driveway. Slow down. We'll go around to the back.
You should have silenced the next Corey.
Undoubtedly, your description's being broadcast from one end of the state to the other.
I'll lay low until things blow over.
That's right, but you'll do it on the coast. Take a plane and fly out. I'll change clothes and get back to town so I can keep in touch with things.
Hold it.
Now the ghost walks right into our hands.
Yourself, or shall I do it for you?
I intend to go on wearing this mask for a long time.
There must be trouble outside. See what it is.
So he can make himself invisible. That explains a lot of things.
You've no time to lose. Tracy's here.
Thank you.
Tracy calling State Police Headquarters.
Come in, Tracy.
I'm following him. He's headed north toward Highway 98.
All right, Tracy, I'll broadcast a general alarm. State Police Headquarters calling all cars.